Everybody knows by now, the Bucks are visiting the Patriots this weekend for Tom Brady's first game back in New England since exiting in free agency after that 2019 season. Tom told reporters yesterday, Bill Belichick and his ex-teammates, they're all on the same page. They know he wants to kick their butts after spending 20 years with that franchise. Shannon, you are predicting the Bucks win by 17.
I do.
Is this Brady versus Belichick face-off the greatest revenge game ever?
No, it's not even close. Not even close. It's LeBron going back to Cleveland.
What?
Yeah, because you have to understand, Skip, nobody has burned Tom Brady's jersey. Mr. Kraft did not write a op-ed in the paper saying the self-proclaimed GOAT. He didn't do that. That's what the owner did. The owners called the man, said the self-prescribed king. you
love it. I love that.
You love
that. That's funny.
All this, talking about all this, and I'm going to win. Yeah. I promise you this, we're going to win before he wins one in Miami. Had Mr. Kraft done that, but also, Skip, there's another thing in play here. LeBron James grew up 30 minutes away. He was a hometown hero. He got drafted to his hometown team, took them from downtrodden, the laughingstock of the NBA, to one of the premier teams in the NBA. And he left. And they didn't like that. The fans didn't like that. LeBron James did not get no applause. Tom Brady, they're going to have a video montage. They didn't put no montage up there of LeBron. Mr. Kraft says it's going to be something that would be befitting of someone that gave us 20 years of service. So for me, it's not even close. Skip, you know the boo. You heard the boos. You heard the burning of the jerseys and what everybody said. It wasn't just Cleveland. It was the world had turned against LeBron James because of what transpired. So for me, it's not even close. I get it because, Skip, there was the acrimony. Now, I get the acrimony between Coach Belichick and Tom, but I still don't believe it rises to the level of what Dan Gilbert felt for LeBron James after leaving him. After he had, like, I had built a training facility close to you. I had given access to your friends and family that no one else had. I had done everything you, and this is what you do. And you couldn't even give me the heads up. You couldn't call me. You had somebody else call me like 5 minutes before you made the announcement. So for me, Skip, I think the greatest revenge game is when LeBron went back to Cleveland. He had 38 points, 15 of 25 shooting, 5 rebounds, 8 assists in 30 minutes. He had 24 in the third quarter alone. The Cavs as a team only had 25. So for me, if the greatest revenge game ever was LeBron going back to Cleveland and destroying them with all the vitriol in the building. Mm. There was no 23s. I guarantee we talked about it yesterday, Skip. 50% of the people in the stands gonna have 12 jerseys on. So I get it. Going back, we've never seen anything like this 20 years in one place. Leave, win a Super Bowl, come back. But you have to understand now, LeBron James, what he had to deal with there, I don't really think it's close, Skip.
Okay. I think you are practicing a lot of revisionist history here.
How?
I'll show you how.
Okay.
I'm about to demonstrate how. First of all, obviously, Tom Brady created a dynasty in Foxborough.
Yes.
Obviously, when he got pushed out the door by Bill Belichick, he had won 6 Super Bowls. Am I right about that? All with game-winning drives in the fourth quarter or overtime. 6 Super Bowls, right?
Yep.
What had LeBron won when he chose to leave Cleveland? What had he won? He had won 0.
He won nothing.
Okay, he got to 1 finals against my San Antonio Spurs, and he got swept. I thought he could have at least win 1 game against the Spurs. I know they were dynastic in and of themselves with 3 Hall of Famers, but I thought he could just win 1 game, and he could not. Then what happened against Orlando? It was 2 years before he left. What did he do? He hit the shot heard round the world to win game 2 at home. Remember? It's all I heard about for like 48 hours. And then the bottom fell out because everybody said, here he comes. It's going to be LeBron versus Kobe in the finals.
Right.
It's what we all were just living for at that moment. And the bottom fell out all the way through game 6, and they lost in 6 games to Dwight Howard's Orlando Magic.
Right.
Correct?
Right.
Then what happened in his final playoff series in Cleveland? He flamed out worse than ever because in games 4, 5, and 6, it got so bad that ESPN reported that LeBron needed to be sedated before each of those games, according to LeBron's inner circle, because he was having an issue with a teammate in the locker room. You remember this very well. Dan Gilbert was beside himself and was so angry that LeBron shrank in games 4, 5, and 6 after playing one of the great games of his career in game three at Boston, that Dan Gilbert accused LeBron of quitting. Mm-hmm. And that's it. Quitting!
Yes.
He used the Q word. He went public with the Q word. He told the Associated Press he quit on us in games 4, 5, and 6.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what an ugly way to bow out in your home area.
Thank you.
Okay, so the problem here with your analogy is that you've got the wrong party here, because the wronged party in Brady Belichick is Brady. He was the one who got pushed out the door. LeBron didn't get pushed out the door. He walked out the door. And he did so with the decision, which I have no problem with, except he made one PR faux pas to me in the decision as he talked to Jim Gray live on national TV. He needed to at least give a thimble full of gratitude back to the fans who had stuck with him in his home area. But he was so angry at Dan Gilbert already. He hadn't been accused of quitting just yet.
Mm-hmm.
But they had fallen completely apart that LeBron wouldn't even call him to explain why he was leaving.
Right.
Right?
Right.
Dan Gilbert was sort of, he got the news when everybody else got
exactly.
the news. And he was furious about that.
Yes.
And Cleveland fans were furious that LeBron couldn't even thank them for their loyal support.
Thank you.
What do you mean, thank you?
Skip, you're making my point, because all the things you said, all the flame outs that had transpired, and you saying you couldn't stay here and win us one, you left. Tom Brady had won 6. Mr. Kraft said, if anybody deserved to leave, it's Tom Brady. I wish all my employees,
okay, he's the wronged party, right? He was the guy who took the fall there. LeBron didn't take the fall.
Yeah.
The Cleveland and the Cavaliers took the fall.
No, Skip, but they said the self-prescribed mm-hmm. king. Everybody said, you're not the king. Have you seen one jersey burn?
But that's after he left.
Yeah.
He chose to leave. Did Tom choose to leave?
Skip,
no.
Let me ask you a question. Will Tom Brady be booed or will he be cheered when he goes back to the stadium?
I don't know for a fact, but he might be politely applauded. I'm not sure he's going to be cheered, but I think we both agreed. I think you'll see about 50% of the fans wearing number 12 jerseys.
I want to turn my volume up on my TV because I believe he'll be cheered. Also, let me ask you a question. Did they have a video montage? Did they play a video montage of LeBron James in the arena? Because that's what they're going to do for him in the Patriots at Gillette Stadium.
I know, but it was one of the ugliest exits in the history of sports.
Yeah.
Right?
Skip, that's the revenge.
Well, so what's the revenge? So you go back and play a team that is terrible. The Patriots aren't terrible. They're still credible, right?
That remains to be seen.
Okay, well, this definitely remains to be seen, because I'm looking at the box score from that December 2nd, 2010 game, and I will give you this. LeBron was outstanding in that game. And I was impressed because, as I talked about Brady, sometimes you go in and you're so overamped, you want it so badly, you want to sort of rub their nose in it for reasons I don't know, because you actually, you already rubbed their nose in it by leaving.
Right.
But the point is, you want to show them how great you still are.
Right.
And you go in and you hang 38 on them, as you talked about in the third quarter. He just went off on, he destroyed them in the third quarter. But look who he was destroying. Look who the leading scorer for the Cavs was off the bench was Booby with 21.
Right.
And they had no starter in double figures except Mo Williams had 11.
Oh, hold on. But you do realize that was the team that LeBron James had gotten to the Eastern Conference Finals. Mm. Now you say, look at that team.
Mm.
Now that LeBron is, now all of a sudden you want to play with.
Okay, well, my point is, here are the rest of the starter scores against LeBron that night. J.J. Hickson got 6. Anderson Varejao had 4 and 8 rebounds. Anthony Parker had 3 points, and Joey Graham had 4 points. That's what was left. That's what LeBron left in Cleveland, because they got caught unawares. They were shocked because Dan Gilbert thought he was going to resign.
That's what Dan Gilbert had given LeBron James, and that's what you expected him to beat the Celtics with.
Okay.
That's what LeBron had. Skill him.
Look what LeBron went back in there. Guess who's riding shotgun that night? How about D. Wade? He scored 22. How about Chris Bosh? He added 15.
Oh.
How about James Jones off the bench had 18?
Okay, but how about this? Guess who's riding with shotgun? Mike Evans. Guess what? Chris Godwin. Guess what? AB. Guess what? Another Gronk.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
I get, they just won the Super Bowl.
Thank you.
Okay. But this is revenge, because father pushed son out the back door and said, you can't do this anymore. You are washed up. Imagine, that's what father told son.
Imagine if Mr. Kraft had taken out an op-ed in the Boston Globe or the Herald or whatever. I think it's the Globe. I think that's the Globe.
Well, there's also the Boston Herald.
Okay. Yeah, and said,
yeah.
The self-prescribed, described GOAT ain't it. We did this, and we're going to win championships. We won't win a championship without you.
Okay, but he couldn't do it because the guy had won 6 Super Bowls. LeBron had won exactly 0.
But, Skip, LeBron James didn't give himself that name. Tom Brady didn't give himself that name. Others gave him that name. Sports Illustrated called him King James. He had Chosen One. They gave him the name Chosen One. Now, he had it tatted on his back.
Wait a second. He had it tatted across the top of his back in high school. Chosen One.
I know.
What?
Yeah, because Sports Illustrated
gave him. You did it.
Sports Illustrated gave him that name. Skip.
Well, you don't think he was validating it?
I know a lot of guys that got nicknames that have been given to them by someone else tatted on them. Mm. Tom Brady, Skip, is coming back. That environment is going to be nothing like what LeBron James faced going back to the Q.
Okay, I agree with you. But again, LeBron did it.